from Las Vegas, it's theCUBE, covering Dell EMC World 2017. Brought to you by Dell EMC.
Welcome back here in Las Vegas at the Venetian as theCUBE continues our coverage of Dell EMC World 2017 along with our co-host Paul Gillen. I'm John Walls. Good to have you with us as we I guess we're coming down the home stretch.
We are.
Day one.
The end of the day.
Yeah, here at Dell EMC World 2017. With us now is Chandoboy Mondal, who is a product marketing director at Dell EMC. And double dipping on us. We just had you on just a few moments ago, so this is nice. We get two shots.
Thanks for having me.
Good to have you back with us. Yeah, it's good.
Thanks for having me.
So before we were talking about Extreme.io, what you were doing in the healthcare space, moving over now to copy data management, a different part of your portfolio and kind of what's up in that world with you. So just give us a little rundown, an overview of what you're up to right now.
Sure. So let's start with what exactly is copy data problem, right? Why it's a problem and why we need to be solving it. So if you think of any business application, it comes with its production data. But for every bit of production data, you have many different copies. For example, when you are developing applications, you need copies for your development and testing. You need copies for your backup. You need copies for running your analytics environment. So it's for every single production database, typically we see 5 to 12 copies of that data. And in fact, IDC estimates the copy data sprawl is like $40 billion market, and 60% of all the data that exists are on copies. Now, our mission, especially with Dell EMC Extreme.io, is to solve that copy data problem, giving the customers back a lot in terms of the storage efficiencies, and not only is the storage TCO, but transforming the business workflows with the copy data management so that they can realize storage and infrastructure savings, but also the business impact from transforming the application workflows and bringing new products to market in a much quicker way.
So you said a $40 billion market. I mean, what are the costs here? Is it just storage costs? Is it bandwidth? Is it errors? Lack of data being out of sync?
So the cost here has multiple components, right? So first of all, there is the cost of the raw storage where you need to put the data on. But then there comes the cost of managing the storage. How do you figure out where your backup copies are? If you need to restore, where are you going to get the data from? Is the cost of inefficiencies, meaning like if your developer, who is the highly paid, highly productive guy supposed to be, right, he is waiting for the DBA or the storage admin to give the copy that he needs, then that's a wastage of money, right? So it's not just the infrastructure cost, but also the soft cost of like your ability to bring the product to the market in a quicker way, addressing your customer needs in a quicker way. So that adds up, and those are the components in like how IDC values this entire market.
So, I mean, are you talking about, I guess what I'm hearing here, if you've got 5 to 12 copy sets out of data, I mean, massive amounts of waste in some cases, right? And maybe some of your clients, or they'd like to know where everything is, but do they lose track of it? And so it's taking up space, taking up money, taking up time. Are these the problems that they're facing?
Yes, yes.
All right, so then what's the answer then in terms of this better identification? Is X2 get to the heart of that and help them in terms of better efficiencies?
So how do we achieve that efficiencies? Now, one thing is first of all, if you can consolidate all of your copies into one single platform, and copies are duplicate bits, right? So, first of all, the first thing in the process is you eliminate all the duplication that exists in your storage, right? You have your production database, and you have your copies, which are, if not unique, then basically should not take up any extra space. Now, you take those copies and make it like a repurposed one. So for example, your developer can run tests on it. So when the writes are coming in, only the changes that are happening, that should go into the storage. So that's part A. Part B is when you are running production environment as well as workloads on your copies, you need huge performance with consistently low latency because you cannot impact your production SLAs. You have to meet that.
You can tell them, hang on, I've got something else going on over here, right?
So you need a platform that can handle consistently high performance with low latency, no matter what workload you are running. And then the copies themselves need to be very efficient. They should not take any extra space unless there is something unique. And they should be able to perform just as well as in a production volume. The third part of this is you need to orchestrate the entire process, right? I mean, you as an Oracle admin, you really do not need to worry about how and where the storage is going to be saved for your copies. You click on a button, and it should do all the steps necessary right from your application console down to the storage. So this is the application orchestration that we inbuilt with AppSync and Xtreme.io. And then we have APIs that our customers can use to provide their own service catalog. So using these pillars, we consolidate all the copies on the same platform, running different applications with the same SLAs. Okay, and that kind of helps the customers to bring products faster and address the copy needs.
Now, this is a very hot market right now, and I'm thinking there are some startups, and I'm thinking of Actifio and Catalogic in particular, that say that you shouldn't have many copies, you should have one copy, and then you should have pointers to that. What's your opinion of that? What are the pros and cons of that approach versus yours?
So, our approach, essentially, I mean, since you mentioned, right, there are copy data management vendors, what they're doing is, you have your production, then you make a gold copy of your production, and from that gold copy, you run off different applications on those copies, right? So here, you are introducing another element, another like software, and another appliance, so to speak, to manage the copies. What we are doing is kind of like, you don't need that extra copy that your another third-party provider can provide, and then there are performance implications. With the integrated copy data management that we are offering, the reason we can do it is all of our metadata is in memory, it does not consume any extra space for storage, and no matter what the workload is, we can offer consistently high latency because everything is, the metadata is operating from the memory itself. So the way the third parties are doing, we do it the same way, even better, and at the production level.
Another thing, and forgive me my technical ignorance here, but David Florey at Wikibon has talked a lot about the benefits of flash storage in that you don't have to create copies. You can create a single copy in flash and then multiple users or applications can work from that. Do I have that straight? He says that's a game changer.
Yes, that will be the game changer, and that's really like what we do. The caveat to that is, when you are creating the copies and you want to run applications on the copies, your production should not be impacted and the copies should also be able to deliver the same performance. And that part has been the challenge with other solutions in terms of providing the same performance, the same data services on the copies themselves. That's the area we solve with our intelligent content-aware in-memory metadata architecture with Xtreme.io.
You know, you're talking about integrated data management just a little bit ago. I mean, from a real life perspective, I mean, can you give us an idea about maybe a success story, somebody that you can point to and say, this is how they incorporated that into their process, ICDM worked for them, and we can make it work for you too.
So I'll give you an interesting statistic. We have 3,000 plus customers running Xtreme.io in production, and we get all the phone home data at our end, and we can see what they're doing. Now, for Xtreme.io customers, 56% of the copies that they're making, they are running workloads on them. They're not just for local data protection. And all the IOs that Xtreme.io arrays out there in the field are seeing, 40% of the IOs are because of the copies. So we see it across the board on the customers. I have many examples. For the sake of time, I'll just pick one. So we all know Moen. They are the leading North American manufacturer of the faucets, right? They have, they are a SAP shop, and they have like a lot of SAP landscapes in there. Like with before Xtreme.io, they could not keep up with the backups and the copies that they needed. With after moving to Xtreme.io, that now they can actually take the copies of their production SAP landscapes twice a day. They are query long-running reports. They are actually running like 90% shorter. And in fact, I mean, we were talking with RVH literally like before this segment, right? He was also talking about how efficient their copies are. I was talking with Scripps Health, who are also like going to be presenting in here. They run like 3,000 copies in their environment with Xtreme.io and AppSync, and like it's all working great. No impact on the performance, and they're meeting their SLAs.
Well, your performance on theCUBE has been outstanding.
Okay.
Back-to-back segments, we appreciate the time. Chan Inmue, thanks
Thank
for being
you.
With us.
And, it was a
best
pleasure.
Best of luck down the road and continued success here at the show as well.
Thank you, it was a pleasure.
We will continue with more from theCUBE here in Las Vegas. We are live at Dell EMC World 2017.